When a property is tenant occupied, how will the lease impact the transaction?
Hello, I'm Michelle Belchek. This is Derek Bernardo, and we are excited to help you today work through transactions when your purchaser is buying a property which has a current tenant in it.
It's important to remember that the lease will actually be inherited by the purchaser, which is why it's really important for the buyer to receive a copy of the lease for their review as soon as possible.
Yes, and if you are in a transaction where the seller says there is no written lease signed by the tenant, that they're just going month to month, you want to be certain that there is one by even putting a contingency in the contract. Because if you did have to evict the tenant, whether you are considering that or not, maybe the purchaser is buying it for an investment property, but for an eviction to take place, there has to be a landlord-tenant relationship established. A lease is very important.
That's a great point. One common question is, should we do anything special with the actual offer itself when we're crafting it? And we definitely want to include a special stipulation that addresses the transfer of the security deposit and also the proration of monthly rent. Now, the Georgia Association of Realtors does have a special stipulation specifically for this, and that is available in the Special Stipulations Forms Library.
That's great information. And what would we do if the seller says the tenant said that they'll be out before our closing? Another consideration.
And another great point in getting a copy of the lease, because we want to look at the lease and confirm that the lease term has ended, and if not, has proper notice been sent or has an amendment to the lease been signed?
Right. And it's okay, really, if the tenant did want to move out, regardless of the term, but what we want to do is protect our buyers. And the way that we can do that is to put in the special stipulations a contingency that the tenant and all of their personal belongings will be removed from the property 3 days prior to closing. And that way we can go through the home, be certain that there's been no material alterations with the tenant moving out, and then we're not going to have to be in a situation where we're trying to evict someone as soon as we get there.
Absolutely. And when it comes to the security deposit, one frequently asked question is, how soon after the expiration or termination of a lease should the security deposit be returned? And general Georgia landlord-tenant law and also most lease agreements is going to say 30 days. So it's within 3 business days after the expiration or termination of a lease that a landlord really wants to conduct a walkthrough and notate any damage, because if there's going to be any retention from the security deposit for damages, it's really important for the tenant to receive a comprehensive list of those damages as well as reasonable estimates for the deductions.
And for new investors, whether you are a real estate agent investor or you don't have a license and you're a new investor, we would certainly recommend reviewing the Georgia landlord tenant law, just because it'll give you a lot of great information and even tips and frequently asked questions, which is wonderful, and it's a great way to stay out of litigious situations that were not necessary.
We hope that you found this information helpful. Michelle, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Derek.
We appreciate you.